Attention. Today at 10 a.m., the regional director is making an unexpected visit.
What? The regional director is coming and he wants to have all of this data in all these different sheets combined into a single one. What are we gonna do?
First, get me a coffee. Let's think how we can set this up properly. So he's a big fan of having everything dynamic. He hates copy and paste. So we're not gonna do that. We're just gonna copy and paste the headers on a new sheet because that's not gonna change. But the data side of things, we're not gonna copy and paste. Instead, we're gonna use a function to keep everything dynamic. I'm gonna use the VSTACK function. This allows me to combine different ranges with one another. The first range is sitting on my first sheet, Control Shift to the right, Control Shift down to select it, then use the Excel formula separator, and let's just move on to the next sheet and follow the motions, Control Shift right, Control Shift down, and then finally the last sheet. Let's repeat that, close the bracket, press Enter, and we have all of our data combined together in a dynamic way onto a single summary sheet. Let's quickly auto-fit this and adjust the number formatting. And that's it, we're done.
But wait, that's not the latest file. You have an old version. The latest file has like over 15 tabs.
Hold my coffee. Okay, so since we have a lot of tabs here, it doesn't make sense to reference each of these separately. We still want to keep things super dynamic, but we're going to use a slightly different approach. We're going to start off with VSTACK, go to the first tab here, hold down the Shift key, go all the way and select the last tab that we want included. This now is a 3D reference. It's automatically going to include all the sheets that are in between the first one and the last one. The range that I want is this, but some sheets have more data, some have less data. So in my case, to be on the safe side, I'm going to go with 50, but of course you can go with a bigger range. Depends on how much data you have. And now we have all of these sheets appended with a simple formula.
But now you have all of these zeros in the middle. This looks horrible. What's he going to think?
Don't worry, we're just going to use the filter function and filter these out. So we're going to start off with filter. Our array is our VSTACK. I'm just going to copy this because we're going to use it again. We want to include values that don't have a zero. So I'm going to use VSTACK and our reference is going to be the first column. So we're going to go with A2 to A50 and check whether this range does not equal to nothing. So basically we're only including rows where A has a value in it. Close bracket, press enter, and now those zeros are gone.
Can you sort these by product? I'm sure he's gonna want that.
Of course, we just have to put this inside the sort function. So that's our result. We're gonna start off with sort because we wanna sort our filtered result. The column that we want to sort this by is 1, 2, 3, 4th column. So we're going to go to the side here, put the column ID, which is 4. The sort order, whether we want ascending or descending, I'm just going to go with the default 1 ascending, or you can skip that argument altogether because default is ascending. Press enter, and we have our stacked list automatically sorted by product in ascending order.
What if he wants to add data from another file and drop it in the middle of these? Is it going to work? I hope it does.
Okay, so let's test it out. This is another file that I have, and I have extra data in this R10/3 tab. And I'm going to drag and drop it here, and we're going to see if our index function automatically updates. So notice in this tab, I have absorbent cotton. So that should show up first because we're sorting by product name. Does it really work? Does everything automatically update like we want it to? Let's click, drag, drop it here. And now what happens? It's right here. We can see data from Miller, which was the data that we just added, automatically populated in here and automatically sorted as well. So that's the beauty of using 3D functions because it includes anything that's in between your first and the last sheet that you have referenced in your formula. VSTACK allows us to automatically stack the data. Filter allows us to get rid of the empty spaces or the zeros. And sort allows us to dynamically sort our results. Now, even if the regional director wants multiple levels of sorting, so we want to sort by product and then by sales, but by sales in descending order, we can also do that. So let's just be fully prepared. All we have to do is update our sort index and include the different columns that we want to have. Because we're going to be referencing multiple columns, we need to find the curly braces or curly brackets and type in the column IDs. So one column I want to sort is still product name, which is the fourth column. Then I'm going to add in the total sales column, which is the seventh column. So I'm going to put a 7 and close the curly bracket. Now I can define the sort order. Because I'm using the curly brackets, I have to define those with curly brackets as well. The sort order for product is ascending, that's a 1. The sort order for total sales is descending, that's -1. Let's close that bracket, press enter, and now we have our multiple level of sorting. Products are sorted in ascending order, whereas the total sales within the products is sorted in descending order. That's it, let's get to our meeting. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this slightly different video. We just had to switch things up for a change. Let me know what you thought about it. And if you're new here, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. And I'm gonna see you in the next video.